Welcome to Driven Flawed. Today I'm with a bit of SC and well, to be honest, I'm kind of on the fence with it. I've had it for a couple of months, but today I'm going to be out and about in it and give it another chance. When you pick up an old car like this, there's just something about running around in it that you end up either trusting it or not. There was a lot going on when I collected this. There was other stuff happening. We'd not long had the XJS, which ended up, you know, needing a lot of attention to get it ready for the wedding. I think I was just pretty unhappy with the way that this had let me down coming home. Since then, it has sat and not really been doing a great deal. And because I've had it hidden away, covered away, I haven't been looking at it and I haven't been thinking, oh, it is a lovely looking car. I've just been imagining it in my mind, thinking about it being a bit of an awkward, odd car. Today, I've had an opportunity to get back into it, get it back out. I've been reconditioning the battery, which also went flat after I decided I didn't love it anymore. Now I've kind of just got it back up to speed again and just driving around in it. It's got such a lovely ride. It's got such a nice ride. How quickly do we fall in and out of love with these things? And I have just forgotten what it was like. Look at that. I mean, it's really got some movement to it. And yet, I pull off and it just does GT in a beautiful way. It has that nice combination of a bit of punch and a bit of power, but it's actually very smooth. These seats are just glorious. They are actually weirdly supportive and comfortable, and at the same time they feel like you're sitting in your Uncle John's leather sofa. I don't seem to be having any issues like overheating or some of the other stuff that plagues cars of this sort of era. It is behaving like an extraordinarily expensive car from the 1980s. And it may just be getting back under my skin again. Having walked home after the collection went wrong, I picked the car up a couple of days later and I was delighted that the guys were basically saying there was nothing massively wrong with it. There was a power issue with the starter motor and the solenoid. Basically, it was getting about 7 watts. It just wasn't beefy enough. Now, this car is, for some unknown reason, has got this aftermarket starter, which tells me that probably the GM starter that's sitting built into these cars with the key has probably just gone. And when it went, for whatever reason, the owner at the time decided, rather than just get a new starter and do it properly, the owner decided to put a on dash starter button in place, which just seemed like a bizarre thing to do. But anyway, they have, and actually it functions quite well, but it only functions quite well when it has enough power. And that was basically the problem. Having fallen out in love with the bitter in about 2 days flat, I started looking at 911s, at the 996 911 turbo to be precise, which I think has an awful lot going for it. And I'm still rather interested in that. But I was also kind of interested in the Esprit Turbo, Series 3 Turbo, which I think is an excellent car. If you get the right example, I'd be very taken with one of those. But I was starting to think that the bitter was a bit of a dog. I bought something I shouldn't have bought. What was I doing? It was totally unreliable. I didn't like it anymore. I was being an extraordinarily fickle friend. However, having spent a little bit more time with it now, cleaned it up, you can see this interior is just beautiful. I really don't know that I want to get rid of it. Thanks for joining me today. It really helps if you click the like button and subscribe to keep in touch. And why not check out the next video on the fabulous Toyota Supra?